morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the entire part related to electromagnetic waves. Before going to explain electromagnetic waves, these electromagnetic waves are discovered by the scientist Maxwell in the year 1865 and practically proved by the scientist Hertz in the year 1892. So, how Maxwell started the concept of electromagnetic waves means? To explain this point, we are going to take a charge which may be positive or negative. Whenever we have taken a charge, automatically it produces some electric lines of force. The lines which are produced around this charge are going to be called electric lines of force. The total number of electric lines of force is called as electric flux, which is indicated by pi v. Whenever we heard the word flux, it indicates number. If it is electric flux, means number of electric lines of force. So, if you are going to take a charge which may be positive or negative, it generates a number of lines of force. These lines of force are going to be called electric lines of force, and the total number of lines of force is called electric flux. In the same way, if you are going to take a magnet having two poles north and south, this magnet also produces a number of lines in such a way which starts from north pole and ending at south pole. So, these lines which are going to be produced by a magnet are going to be called magnetic lines of force. And the total number of magnetic lines of force is going to be called magnetic flux, which is indicated by phi b. Here B indicates electric field, whereas B indicates magnetic field. Flux is indicated by pi, where flux indicates a number. It uses the number of magnetic lines of force, whereas this one uses the number of electric lines of force. Now, what Maxwell told is, if magnetic field converts into electric field, is there a chance to convert electric field into magnetic field? It was the question raised by Maxwell, which used the concept of electromagnetic waves. So, the word clearly indicates electromagnetic means it contains two fields. One is electric field and the second one is magnetic field. Both electric and magnetic fields are always perpendicular to each other. These electric magnetic waves do not require any medium. Even this can travel through vacuum. Even though electric and magnetic fields are perpendicular to each other, always these two fields are in phase. Phase means if one field is acting along x-axis, the second field is acting along y-axis. That is what we are going to call it as phase. Now, if you want to discuss about the important points related to electromagnetic waves, these electromagnetic waves requires two fields. First one is going to be called electric field, and the second field required is magnetic field. Always these two fields are perpendicular to each other. Means if electric field acts along x-axis, magnetic field acts along y-axis, and the electromagnetic wave will be moving along z-axis. So, the electromagnetic wave will be shown in such a way. This electric field which is acting along x-axis is given by Ex is equal to E naught into sine kx minus omega t. And the magnetic field which is acting along y-axis is given by By is equal to maximum, we are going to use a word amplitude. Amplitude indicates maximum. So E naught is going to be called amplitude of electric field, and B naught is called amplitude of magnetic field. And this constant K is called wave constant, whose formula is K is equal to 2 pi by lambda, where lambda is called wavelength, and this omega is going to be called angular velocity, whose formula is 2 pi by t, and we can also write 1 by t as frequency, so omega can be written as 2 pi mu. So these are the two standard equations for electric field along x axis and magnetic field along y axis, which are given by Ex is equal to E naught into sin kx minus omega t, and By is equal to B naught into sin kx minus omega t, where k indicates a wave constant whose formula is 2 pi by lambda, and omega indicates wave angular velocity whose formula is 2 pi by t. We can also write 2 pi mu by as frequency is equal to 1 by t. And already discussed, electromagnetic waves are always transverse in nature. Transverse means perpendicular. If electric field is along x axis, magnetic field is along y axis. This electromagnetic waves requires electric field and magnetic field which are perpendicular to each other. And I'll give phase. These electromagnetic waves do not require any medium, means they can even travel through vacuum. These electromagnetic waves will travel with the velocity of light, which is increasing. As these electromagnetic waves in presence of vacuum will travel with velocity of light, whose formula is given by C is equal to 1 by under root of mu naught epsilon naught, which is equal to E naught by B naught. Just to be discussed, E naught indicates amplitude of electric field and B naught indicates amplitude of magnetic field. So the ratio between amplitudes of electric field and amplitude of magnetic field will use the velocity, which is equal to 1 by under root of mu naught epsilon naught, where epsilon is the word used in the electric field, which is going to be called permittivity of free space. And mu naught is the word used in magnetism, which is going to be called permeability of free space. Whenever we indicate not at the suffix, it indicates free space, means vacuum. So it is a standard equation which is used to calculate most of the problems in electric fields. So these equations which indicate velocity of light and the equation which indicates electric and magnetic fields will play a crucial role in doing problems. If you go to the next formula related to electromagnetic waves, if we are going to get a surface, on this surface, if we are going to send a electromagnetic wave, this electromagnetic wave on this surface will use some pressure. Such a pressure acting on this surface is going to be called radiant pressure. Whose formula for this radiant pressure is given by I by C, where I indicates intensity, C indicates velocity of light. So whenever any electromagnetic wave is allowed to fall on a surface, it produces some pressure. Such a pressure is called radiant pressure, whose formula is I by C, where I indicates intensity and C indicates velocity of light. Due to this pressure, we are going to calculate the formula for momentum, which is given by u by c. Already we are well familiar with c. C indicates velocity of light. U indicates energy. So the formula becomes energy by velocity of light. So whenever we are going to send any electromagnetic wave onto a surface, it produces some pressure. Such a pressure is called radiative pressure, which is given by the formula I by C, where I indicates intensity and C indicates velocity of light. On the same surface, it produces some momentum, which is given by P is equal to U by C, where U indicates energy and C indicates velocity of light. There is a lot of difference between capital U and small u. Capital U indicates energy and small u indicates energy density. So whenever you are going to do problems, you should be well noted that capital U and small u are different. Capital U indicates energy density and small u indicates energy density. Now we are going to calculate energy densities in electric and magnetic fields. In case of electric field, energy density is given by half epsilon naught E square. In case of magnetic field B, the energy density is given by B square by 2 nu naught. B square by 2 nu naught. As we know the terms, E indicates electric field, B indicates magnetic field, epsilon naught indicates permittivity of free space, and nu naught indicates permeability of free space. And finally, pressure along with momentum will use some force. This force can be calculated directly using Newton's second law, F is equal to ma, which we can write it as dp by dt, where small p indicates momentum. So they can write force simply as F is equal to p by t. So these formulas help us a lot while solving every problem in electromagnetic waves, whether it is board or KSET or in a neat examination system. So once again, if we are going to take a surface, on this surface, if we are going to send electromagnetic wave, it produces some pressure. Such a pressure is called radiative pressure, whose formula is given by I by C, where I indicates intensity, C indicates velocity of light. This intensity generally is going to be given as power by area, where P indicates power, A indicates area. Now coming to momentum. Momentum is given by U by C, where U indicates energy and C indicates velocity of light, which gives some force. According to Newton's second law, F is equal to ma, which is equal to dp by t, which we can write simply as F is equal to p by t. Capital U indicates energy, small u indicates energy density. In case of electric field, energy density is equal to half epsilon naught E square. In case of magnetic field, we can write it as B square by 2 nu naught. And finally, these electromagnetic waves are used to transfer energy and momentum from one point to another point. If you are going to show electromagnetic wave in such a way, if this is point O, this is point A, and this is point B, from point O to A, it transfers energy and momentum. The main motto of electromagnetic waves is nothing but that to transfer energy and momentum from one point to another point. Such energy transfer from one point to another point is given by a vector S bar, where S bar is called pointing vector. So pointing vector is indicated by S bar, which indicates the flow of energy from one point to another point, which is given by S bar is equal to E bar cross H bar, which is equal to 1 by 2 naught of E bar plus a B bar. Where E bar indicates electric field, B bar indicates magnetic field, and now we are going to show a new term H bar, which is called intensity of magnetic field. So this H bar indicates the intensity of a magnetic field. So these are the important formulae related to electromagnetic waves, which explains how energy and momentum can be transferred from one point to another point. So for solving problems, just we are going to write the list of formulae which we are going to use in electromagnetic waves. We discussed electromagnetic waves traversing without requirement of medium, means they can travel through vacuum. When they travel through vacuum, the speed is given by C is equal to 1 by under root of U naught epsilon naught, which is equal to ratio between electric fields and magnetic fields, which are maximum. If these electromagnetic waves are traveling through a medium, then instead of C, we have to replace by B. Instead of U naught, you should take U. Instead of epsilon naught, you should take epsilon. This is the formula for velocity of the electromagnetic wave when traveling through medium. And we discussed the main motto of electromagnetic waves is to transfer energy and momentum. Further, we just discussed the formula of pressure, which is given by I by C. Whereas the formula for the momentum, which is indicated by small p, is given by the formula U by C, where U indicates energy and C indicates velocity of light. And finally, we discussed force, which is given by F is equal to dP by dt. Simply we can write it as P by T. And then, electromagnetic waves have energy as well as energy density. The energy density in electric field is given by UE is equal to half epsilon naught E square. And energy density in magnetic field is given by B square by 2 mu naught. So these are the formulas which are going to be used to do the problems on electromagnetic waves. Along with this formula, we are going to discuss a concept called as displacement current. Generally indicated by ID. So displacement current, the word clearly indicates displacement means changing. So the current produced by changing the electric field is called as displacement current, whose formula is given by ID is equal to epsilon naught into d pi e by dt. So this is the formula which we are going to be used to calculate displacement current. If you want to know the derivation, for this sake, we are going to take two metal plates. Between them, we have taken a surface S. These metal plates will have positive charge and negative charge. Due to this, automatically, it produces an electric field. Whenever there are charges, it generates an electric field. Already we know electric field is indicated by E. So the relation to calculate this displacement current is based on this electric field, where the electric flux is given by the formula E into A. A indicates area of the surface, E indicates electric field produced due to the charges, and I indicates electric flux. In the last class we discussed, electric field intensity E is given by sigma by epsilon naught. This sigma is called surface charge density. This surface charge density sigma is indicated by charge by area. So E indicates electric field intensity of a metal plate, which is given by sigma by epsilon naught. So if you place here, tiny is equal to, instead of E, if you write as sigma by epsilon naught into U. But instead of sigma, they can write charge by area. So just by pressing here, instead of sigma, charge by area by epsilon naught into A. So it becomes Q by A into A by epsilon naught, where A attraction will use electric flux as Q by epsilon naught. If we take epsilon naught to the other side, epsilon naught into pi E is equal to Q. So our motto is to calculate current. To calculate current, the formula is I is equal to dQ by dt. Rate of flow of charge is called current. So from that side, we are going to differentiate on both sides. So d by dt of epsilon naught into pi E is equal to d by dt of Q. But dQ by dt, just we discussed, it is nothing but current. Here, in case of differentiation, epsilon naught is a constant, so we can write it outside. If you write it outside, epsilon naught into d pi E by dt, which can be taken as, instead of dQ by dt, we can write it like, such a current is called as displacement current. So, such an equation, which indicates IE is going to be called epsilon naught into d pi E by dt, such an equation gives a displacement current. From this equation, if you look carefully, displacement current depends on permittivity of free space and electric fields. As this is a constant, displacement current always depends on electric flux. Means, if we increase electric flux, displacement current also increases. That is the relation which we are going to do with respect to displacement current. If we are going to use this topic for further studies, in case of doing anything in terms of competitive error, the first form of error current which we discussed is dQ by dt. Instead of charge, you can write U is equal to CV. So, d by dt of, instead of charge, if you write CV, B capacitance and voltage, C can be written outside, C into dV by dt. If you are going to use parallel plate capacitor, we can write C as epsilon naught A by d. If you plus here, epsilon naught A by d into dV by dt. These are all the formulas which indicates current at different stages. In the same way, we can write this current formula as I is equal to epsilon naught into d pi E by dt. So these are all the formulae related to current in different chapters of electricity and magnetism. So in such a way, using the concept of displacement current, we can get the equation related to current, which is produced due to changing electric field. The main motto to explain displacement current is to change Ampere's law. What is Ampere's law? Generally, Ampere's law can be indicated by integral of B bar dot dl bar is equal to U naught into I, where I indicates current. Instead of this current, we can write it as IC plus ID. This IC is called conduction current, whereas this ID is called displacement current. So, the main motto to explain displacement current is to modify this Ampere's law in such a way where current contains conduction current and displacement current. And finally, to solve the problems in electromagnetic waves, we are going to use a core system related to electromagnetic spectrum. The electromagnetic spectrum contains a core which we have to remember it as G, X, U, V, I, M, R. This is the whole system for the electromagnetic spectrum, where G indicates gamma rays, X indicates X rays, U indicates ultraviolet rays, V indicates visible rays, I indicates infrared rays, M indicates micro, and R indicates radio. So, why we are going to write this code is, if you go from gamma to red, wavelength goes on increasing. If wavelength increases, frequency decreases. Why? The relation is C is equal to nu lambda, nu is equal to C by lambda. As frequency is inversely proportional to wavelength, as wavelength increases, frequency decreases. Here, in this color code system, G indicates gamma rays, X indicates X rays, U indicates UV rays, V indicates visible, I indicates infra, M indicates micro, and R indicates radio waves. This concept can be used to solve any problem in any type of competitive examinations. See, if you go from left to right, wavelength goes on increasing. G stands for gamma, whose wavelength is less than 10 power minus 12 meters. We have to take this value to the next case and should be at the last value. Means, if we come for X rays, whose value lies between 1 nanometer to 10 power minus 12 meters. So the value which we got for gamma should lies at the last for the next value. Means, for X-rays, the wavelength is 1 nanometer to 10 power minus 12 meters. In case of UV, it becomes, this value of 1 nano will comes last. So the value of wavelength for ultraviolet becomes 400 nanometer to 1 nanometer. For ultraviolet rays, the range becomes 400 nanometer to 1 nanometer. In the next case, for visible, this 400 becomes last, so the range becomes 700 nanometers to 400 nanometers. In such a way, the first value in the former case will become the last value in the next case, so that we can remember each value of each radiation very, very easily. If you are going to come from infra, this value will become 1 millimeter to 700 nanometers. The 700 nanometers will come to the next case, which starts from 1 millimeter to 700 nanometers. Coming to micro, it will be 0.1 meter to 1 millimeter. 0.1 millimeter to 1 millimeter. Whereas the last one, radio, whose wavelength is greater than 0.1 meters. In such a way, for gamma, which starts from less than 10 power minus 12 meters, and finally at greater than 0.1 meters. So this is the core system which can be used in any type of cases. If you are going to be asked, calculate the region whose frequency is 10 power 6 hertz. So we have to calculate the region to which this frequency belongs to. Just by using this frequency, we can calculate wavelength using the formula C is equal to nu lambda, C by nu is equal to lambda, C value is 3 into 10 power 8, frequency is 10 power 6. So, wavelength becomes 3 into 8 minus 6, 10 square, so which is equal to 300 meters. As the wavelength is 300 meters, which is greater than 0.1 meter, so that radiation belongs to radio waves. In such a way, using this power system, we can calculate wavelength and frequencies related to any region. So just once again, the color code. from G, X, U, V, I, M, R. So, here which starts from 10 power minus 12 meters, and finally when we enter greater than 0.1 meters. All these problems will make some, any problem related to electromagnetic wave will make somewhat easy. And in case of problems, if the question is asked on reflecting surface, generally if we take mirror, mirror is a reflecting surface. Whatever the radiation we send, it will be reflected back. So, in such cases, you have to take multiple of two. Suppose you have been asked to calculate. If you have been asked to calculate momentum, momentum generally we can take it as u by c. But being a mirror, which is a reflecting surface, you should take a multiples of u by c. Two times. Why? This is the first one and this is the second one. So the change in momentum is p minus of minus p will use two times. So for that sake, we should take a multiples of two in case of reflecting surfaces. So these are all the shortcut methods to solve any problem related to electromagnetic.